and very warm welcome to all of you who have joined here for the 7th edition of the International Day of Yoga 2021. I am Hemchand P. Gupta, yoga teacher at Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose Indian Culture Center. On behalf of the High Commission of India, Kuala Lumpur, would like to take this opportunity to especially thanks ISA Foundation Malaysia, OPO Malaysia, Heartfulness, Malaysian Indian Youth Council, IO Center, Atma Seva Ashram, Malaysia Yoga Wellness, Bharat Club, Sahaj Yoga and Marwari Yoga Manch for taking part at this year's virtual celebrations. We will begin today's program with a special message from His Excellency Sri Mridul Kumar, High Commissioner of India to Malaysia.
A very good day to all the yoga enthusiasts in Malaysia. On behalf of the Indian High Commission and on behalf of the Indian Cultural Center in Kuala Lumpur, I bring greetings and warm wishes to our yoga friends in Malaysia and in India on the occasion of the International Day of Yoga 2021. Like in the past years, we will be celebrating International Day of Yoga with our partner organizations, with Tamil schools, with Gopio, and other like-minded organizations in a very befitting manner. Dear friends, you would recall that it was the Government of India under the leadership of Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi that took this proposal of declaring 21st June as the International Day of Yoga by the United Nations. Through the efforts of Government of India, the UN decided to celebrate 21st June as the International Day of Yoga, and in 2015 it was the first time that this event was done. Since then, it is the 7th year in running. The popularity of yoga, the number of people who have joined this wonderful practice has increased by many folds. Yoga has become the theme of the day. And we are thankful to the Ministry of Ayush, to our Honorable Prime Minister, and to the Government of India for bringing such large awareness about the benefits of yoga to the humanity. The composite mind-body-soul spectrum that it deals with and it enhances brings the benefit of yoga to the entire people worldwide. In these times of pandemic, yoga assumes a great relevance. When we are unable to connect with each other in a one-on-one manner, and when we are confined within the four walls of our house, it is yoga that provides us mental solace, that provides us the happiness of spirituality, and that also keeps us fit physically. I am thankful to our yoga teacher in the Indian Cultural Center, Shri Khemchandji Gupta, who has done a wonderful work in the last 4 years to ensure that the number of yoga followers in Malaysia continue to increase and the yoga practice become more and more popular. I am very happy to announce that in 2019 we had almost 15,000 people which participated in our physical programs in Malaysia in different locations. We had almost 50 Tamilian schools which had students doing these exercises. Regrettably, due to COVID situation in 2020, we could not do the yoga in that grand fashion, but our online programs, which were very ably crafted by the yoga teacher Shri Khemchandji Gupta, they were liked and they were followed. These programs are available on Indian High Commission website, as also on our social media platform, and which have been used in the last 1 year by a number of yoga enthusiasts in Malaysia. I would urge you all to join us in our virtual celebrations organized by the Indian Cultural Center in Kuala Lumpur, in partnership with the Indian High Commission and other organizations, at 6 p.m. in the evening on the 21st June. Our like-minded organizations and partners will join with us throughout the month of June and July in a large number of programs to mark the International Day of Yoga. With these words, I wish you all a very happy International Day of Yoga, and I hope and pray that the practice of yoga brings health, happiness, peace and comfort in our lives. May we pray for collective healing. Sarve bhavantu sukhina, sarve santu niramya, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashte mukh bhag bhaglet. I thank you.
And vertigo. Bring your legs together. Raise your hands. Interlock your fingers. Turn out your palms. Raise your hands over the head. Raise your ribs, heels, stand on your toes. Benefits are posture brings stability and helps to clear up congestion of spinal nerves. Exhale, bring down your heels, release your finger lock and bring down your hands. Padastasana. Pad means feet, hasta means hands. Therefore, Padastasana means taking the palms down towards the feet. Caution, avoid this practice in case of cardiac problem, back pain and during pregnancy. Bring your legs together, raise your hands over the head. With inhalation, stretch your ribs, breathe out and slowly bend forward. Rest your palms beside the feet or hold your ankles. Touch your forehead to the knees if possible. Benefits: makes the spine flexible, improves digestion, prevents constipation, improves blood flow to the head and neck. Now slowly inhale, raise your hands over the head and bring down from the side and relax.
Chakrasana. Ardha means half, chakra means V. In this posture, body resembles
taking all bandwidth,
the shape of a half V. Is the name. Avoid a person, avoid this practice in case of hernia and vertigo
on that day
and during pregnancy.
Because
next practice are the chakrasana. Legs apart, 1.5 feet or 2 feet. Keep your feet parallel. Place your palm on your waist line. Fingers forward, inhale and slowly take backward bending. Posture makes your spine flexible, it strengthens your spinal nerves, helps in cervical spondylitis. Exhale and slowly come back. Gently release your hands, legs together. Next posture is Trikonasana. Tri means three and kona means angle. In this posture, a triangle is made by trunk and body limbs, hence the name. If you are suffering cardiac problem, vertigo and slip discs, should not practice this posture. High blood pressure person can do carefully, so let's practice Trikonasana. Take 3.5 feet or 4 feet distance between your legs. Right foot 90 degree to the right. Raise your hands up to shoulder level, palm facing downward. Breathe out and slowly bend your body to the right. Rest your palms just behind your feet. Stretch your left hand up. in line with the right shoulder. Turn your head and look at the thumb. Your breath should be normal. Posture prevents flat feet. Inhale and slowly come back without any jerk. Right foot in, left foot out. Breathe out and slowly bend your body to the left. Just keep your palm behind your foot. After that, stretch your right hand up, turn your head and gaze at the right thumb. Don't go beyond your body limit. Just follow your body. Strengthens your calf, thigh and waist muscles. Inhale and slowly come back. Bring down your hands and relax together. Sit in Vajrasana, please. Avoid Vajrasana in case of knee pain or ankle pain. Rest your butts between your heels. Touch your toes. Rest your palms on your thighs. Vajrasana prevents arthritis. It improves your digestion if you practice after the meal. Relax yourself. Close your eyes. Concentrate on your breath. Make your respiration natural. Now make your mind for Ustrasana. Ustra means camel. In this posture, body resembles the hump of a camel. Caution, avoid this practice in case of vertigo and during pregnancy. So let's practice Ustrasana. First we'll do half. Knees apart a little, place your palms on your butts, fingers downward. Take your elbows in, open your chest, drop your head slowly, stretch your neck muscles, do gently please, and bend your body. Posture tones your entire spine. Exhale and slowly come back. Enjoy your posture. Now we'll do full. Those who are unable to do full pose, kindly do the same half camel pose. So let's do full pose. So inhale and take your right hand back. Hold your right heel, left hand, left heel. Push your body forward. Drop your head and maintain your posture. Posture broadens your chest, expand your lungs, so improves your lungs capacity. Exhale and slowly raise your left hand, right hand, and sit in Vajrasana. Relax. Next posture is Shashankasana. Shashank means rabbit. A word of caution, avoid this posture in case of acute back pain. So let's practice Shashankasana. Open your knees as much as possible. Place your palms between your knees and walk on your fingers. Stretch your hands in full length. Breathe out and rest your forehead on your mat. Make sure your hands are straight. It's very relaxing posture, very soothing posture. Enhances blood flow to the brain, hands. It alleviates anger, anxiety, frustration, depression. Just close your eyes and feel your posture. Inhale and slowly come back without any jerk. Bring your knees together and release your Vajrasana. Keep your legs straight. Relax in Dandasana. Legs straight. Rest your palms just beside your
hips and legs. Breath should be normal. Now make your mind for Vakrasan. Vakra means twisted. In this posture, spine is twisted, which brings rejuvenating effect on its function. So bring your legs together, please. Let's practice Vakrasan. So fold your right leg, ankle bone and knee bone together. Keep your right hand back. Right hand should be straight. Now bring your left hand over the right knee. Hold your ankle. Twist your trunk to the right. Keep your left leg straight. Too gently. Don't go beyond your body limit, please. And your breath should be normal. It increases your flexibility. Tones your kidneys, makes them healthy. Inhale. Slowly keep your head straight. Release your left hand, right hand, then leg. Now fold your left leg, ankle bone and knee bone together. Keep your left hand back. Bring your right hand over the left knee. Hold your ankle or big toe. Twist your trunk to the left. You may close your eyes and your breath should be normal. Maintain posture for 10 to 15 seconds. It stimulates your pancreas, plays an important role in management of diabetes. Inhale, keep your head straight, release your right hand, left hand, then left leg. Take prone position, come on your stomach. Stretch your hands forward, maximum. Join your legs. Now we are going to do Bhujangasana. Bhujang means cobra. In this posture, upper body is raised like a hook of cobra. Let's practice Bhujangasana. A word of caution, avoid this practice in case of hernia and peptic ulcer and during pregnancy. So fold your both hands, place your palms beside your chest, toes together, elbows with your body, bring your chin onto mat. Now inhale, slowly raise your head, chest up to navel. This is best for stress management, reduces abdomen fat and relieves your back pain. Exhale and slowly come down. Take rest in Makrasana, legs apart, toes out, heel in. Bring your palms one over other. Rest your forehead on the back of the palms and just relax. There are two relaxative postures in yoga, Makrasana and Shavasana. And now you are practicing Makrasana. It promotes relaxation of lower back. Indicates to counter stress and anxiety. Have a little deeper abdominal breathing. Just notice your body relaxation. Slowly come back, bring your legs together, hands with your body. Make your mind for Shavasana, locust pose. Close your fist, place them under your thighs. Bring your chin onto mat. A word of caution, avoid this practice in case of cardiac problem. During pregnancy, after undergoing operation at least for 3 months. Inhale,
Raise both the legs as high as possible. Keep your leg straight. It helps in sciatica and lower back pain. It reduces fat on thigh and butts. Exhale and come back slowly. Relax. Stretch your hands forward, please. Then turn your back, turn your body and take supine position. Come on your back. Relax. Setu Bandhasana. Setu Band means formation of a bridge. In this posture, body is positioned like a setu or bridge. Avoid this posture at the advanced stage of pregnancy. Now, let's practice Setu Bandhasana. Hold your both legs. Bring your heels close to your butts. Feet apart, slow, little. Inhale and raise your back gently. Take support with your hands. Keep your forearm straight under your back. Raise your heels. Tuck your tummy in. And maintain your posture. It relieves depression and anxiety. It strengthens your lower back muscles. Maintain your posture with normal breathing. Bring down your heels with exhalation. Release your hands. Lower your back and keep your legs straight. Relax. Pavan Muktasana. Pavan means wind, Mukta means to make free or release. A word of caution. Avoid this posture during pregnancy and after operation. At least for 3 months. Let's practice Pavan Muktasana. Fold your both legs. Bring your heels close to your butt. Breathe out and bring your knees close to your chest. Hug your knees. Breathe out and raise your head till chin touch the knees. Posture helps in removing wind and flatulence for stomach and intestine. Inhale and slowly bring down your head, release your finger lock, feet on the floor and keep your legs straight. Relax. Uttan Padasana. Uttan means raised, Pad means feet. In this posture, we raise our feet at 45 degree angle. A word of caution, avoid this posture in case of back pain, sciatica pain or slip disc and during pregnancy. Let's practice Uttan Padasana, legs together, hands with your body. Raise both the legs at 45 degree only, keep your legs straight. Your breath should be normal. It balances navel center and builds up abdominal muscles. Exhale and slowly come down. Relax. Ardha Halasana. Ardha means half. Hala means now. Let's practice Ardha Halasana. Legs together, hands with your body. Breathe out and raise both the legs at 90 degrees. Slowly and gently stretch your toes to the knees. Keep your legs straight. Breath should be normal. improves kidney and liver functions, improves digestive health. Slowly come back, lower your leg 60, 30, then flow. Deep rest in Shavasana. Let's proceed towards Shavasana. So legs apart, hands apart. Keep your hands 6 inches apart, palm facing up. Gently close the eyes. Keep your head straight. Place your body on your mat with reverence. Honor your body. Be introvert. Bring your awareness on your breath.
Can someone mute all the participants?
Notice your incoming and outgoing breath. You'll make a journey from toes to head by visualizing each part of the body. Let's bring awareness on your toes.
Requesting for you to mute all the participants.
Make them tension free. Feet, top of the feet, sole of the feet, relax your ankles, make them tension free. Feet bear body weight entire the day. This is the time to relax. Proceed to the calf muscles and relax them. After that, bring your awareness on your knees. Relax your knees, back of the knees, thighs. Relax each and every nerve of the thighs, hips. Bring your awareness on your abdomen. Relax your abdomen. Feel your belly movement, very up and down movement. Belly comes up while you inhale and goes down while you exhale. It is called diaphragmatic breathing. It's very effective. Proceed to the chest and relax your chest, ribs, collarbones. Relax your arms, elbows, forearms, wrist joints, palms, fingers. Pay attention on your back and relax your lower back, spine, shoulder blades. Just feel the whole body is getting relaxed. Relax your neck muscles, chin, lips, cheeks. Beautiful eyes, relax your nose, forehead, skull, and hair. Relax each cell of the body. Our body is made billions and trillions of cells. Relax each and every cell of the body. Each organ, relax each system of the body, each limb of the body, relax the whole body, relax the whole body. Relax the whole body. Now take a deep breath and exhale. Let go of all your efforts. Another deep breath and exhale. Release your body's frustration. Feel, I am blessed, I am in peace, and I am the happiest person in the world. With these thoughts, slowly and gradually become aware of body and surroundings. Then bring your legs together slowly. Turn your body right and take sitting position. Assume any comfortable posture, Padmasana or Sukhasana, back upright. Now we'll practice one cleansing process, that is Kapalbhati. Kapal means forehead, Bhati means shine. Hence, Kapalbhati is an exercise that brings glow on your face and improves oxygen level in the body. Technique, inhale, after that exhale quickly and completely with a blowing sound. Then relax your abdomen, let it come down so air will glide in naturally, and repeat the same process again and again.